hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall also live. As in baptism, Job put on Christ, so in Christ he became clothed with glory. Here and now, dear friends, we are God's children. Let us pray. God of all love, we thank you for all with which you have blessed us to this day. For the gift of joy, days of health and strength, and for the gifts of your abiding presence and promise so often in the days of pain and grief. We praise you for home and for friends, and for our baptism and our place in your church with all who have faithfully lived and died. Above all else, we thank you for Jesus, who knew our griefs, who died for our death and lives for our sake, and who lives and prepares for us. In this day, for our love, our strength, and our needs. Amen and amen. I want to welcome all of you that have come out to share with this family that we've really gathered to have a day of celebration for a life so well lived. Family, thank you for allowing me to be a part of this service. And truly, I hope it will be a blessing and bring great hope and love to each of you. We come together in our grief. We acknowledge to each other our human loss. And we just ask that God will grant to us during this day that we'll find comfort, we'll find hope, and yes, even in this death, we'll find resurrection. Thank you to each of the friends from the family that have come to share in this place. It is a time of sharing, as many of you have already shared with me and shared with the family of your great love and care. And I thank you for those days, and we thank you for this time. As we prepared this service, I can tell you that I became New Hope's pastor 14 years ago, I guess. And in one of my early years, I met Joe, and I'll have more to that story later on, but I found out very early in my ministry here that Joe had some great songs that he loved and great hymns. And at this time, I want to play for our hearing one of those great hymns that he had written on his paper, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
What?
As I said, about 14 years ago, when I came to New Hope Church, really was not my first pastorate, but it was my second. And one of the things I learned very early on was, really, you need to get to know the characters in your church. And as I began looking back, what I felt would be appropriate, I go back to the character in the Old Testament called Micah. And I want to read a selection from two of his chapters. And it goes like this. With what shall I come to the Lord and bow myself before the God on high? Shall I come to him with burnt offerings, with yearling calves? He has told you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you, but to do justice, love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God. The voice of the Lord will call to the city, and it is sound wisdom to fear your name. Hear, O tribe, who has appointed its time. But as for me, I will watch expectantly for the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. Do not rejoice over me, O my enemy. Though I fall, I will rise. Though I dwell in darkness, the Lord is a light for me. It will be a day for building your walls. On that day, your boundary will be extended. This is truly the reading of the Old Testament word this morning. In one of my first weeks there at New Hope, of course, first thing you do is you find out when choir practice is, you want to go introduce yourself to the choir. That particular week, very early on, it wasn't the choir that was rehearsing, it was a trio. And I had to be very honest, I had to ask somebody who the third member of that trio was. But as I walked in and I sat down in the pew, of course, I introduced myself to all of them as their new pastor. But it was Joe, Paul Steele, Mike Tyson. And I sat there for about, I guess, maybe the next 45 minutes to an hour, maybe a little longer than that, as Pat played for the trio. And I just listened to what I thought was some of the most beautiful old hymns on earth as they sang. And I learned real quick, as I approached the members of the trio and told Joe, you know, y'all are really good. You really don't usually find that good of a trio or that good of just a certain set of music people in a church. But they were really good. Now, my qualifications for determining that is I was born and raised on Southern gospel music from the time I was a baby. My mother and father had taken me to gospel concerts and all-night sings and all the other stuff that goes into learning. I'd sung in choirs myself going through ministry and through men's ministry and all the other stuff, and they were really good. Joe said, "Nah, preacher, we ain't that good. We ain't that good." And then as I got to observe Joe and some of the other antics that he pulled throughout men's meetings and even Sunday mornings and prior to church and Sunday times after church, and to some of the tales that I've heard of tricks that have been pulled on him and by him, I realized that what God had led me to was not only a special church, but a special find. A special find. But as I observed some of these antics, some of these tricks firsthand, I realized something else and why this was one of the favorite hymns of Joe. It was about friendship. Joe was a friend to everybody that he met. If you listen to the words of that hymn, we should never be discouraged. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sources stay? Jesus knew our every weakness. Let's take it to the Lord in prayer. Joe was a walking prayer. Joe was a walking friend to so many of us. And you're just an example of being here today of that friendship. Family, you know this already. This is the greatest thing about all of life is being true friends to where we can get away with shenanigans around us. It was one of the, let's just say all preachers are not stuffed shirts. We enjoy a good joke now and then. It kind of breaks the monotony, if you will, of the days of going through trials and tribulations. And I don't know that in my 4 years of ministry here that I know he probably was, but I really never saw Joe all that discouraged. But I can imagine the last years of realizing of aged growth that there would have had to have been times. And even though it might have been not dropping to a knee in prayer to God, I feel sure that having known Joe as I did, there were prayers that came from the heart. Lord, help me. Help me. And you know, as we come here today, one of those phrases from that song stands out. Precious Savior, still our refuge. And for all of us today, in His arms He'll take and shield thee. Thou wilt find solace there. Family, that is where our solace is today. And as the other character in this text, Micah, says, He has told you, O man, what is good and what the Lord requires of you. Do justice. I can't think of how many times I feel sure that there's some friends here in this congregation tonight that could, or this afternoon, if you will, that could tell me the number of times they played tricks on Joe and how many times Joe got it back. Do justice. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that between friends at all. Love, kindness. In so many ways, Eddie and Joe, that was our teaching that he left all of us. Love, kindness with others. Isn't that so great? And to walk humbly with your God. Walk humbly. preacher, we're not that good. I'm going to say something right now. I hope it doesn't surprise anyone. He was a better singer. That trio was a better singer, or was a better group than what any of them wanted to admit. And Joe was a better friend than he would have ever admitted in his own life. To so many of us. So many of us. And I know that through the many years that I've known this church and this family, they come together and help one another. They come together and be the love, the kindness toward each other that will sustain us and give us hope today. A lot of times we're so humble that we don't want the recognition. We just want to help. We just want to love. We just want to be there for this family now. We just want to be there for each other as friends. As for me, I will watch expectantly for the Lord. Something Joe has realized. He's now home in eternity with the Lord. I will wait for the God, my salvation. It's tough waiting. 87 years tough for Joe. He's arrived. But the future is still for us in all of life. The Lord is a light for me. Oh, what a friend he had in Jesus. Oh, what a friend he had in community, in church, and others that were outside just New Hope, but in the community. Oh, what a friend, family, he was for us. Miss Lillian, it's tough. I know it all too well. Eddie and Joe, it's we come together now in that kindness. And we're with each other, and we call upon our friends when there's a need. You will be, as a family, lifted up in prayer. I know that from this church. And I know that from this beauty. Oh, what a day it is. I would be remiss if I didn't play at least one Southern gospel song. Because I know that Joe loved Southern gospel. They sang Southern gospel to a great extent. Listen now as to the words of this song, Go Rest High.
Only you.
Let us pray. Now may the God of peace, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, make you complete in every good thing, working among us, that is, which is pleasure, which is pleasing in his sight through Jesus Christ. May the blessing of God be among you and be with you and remain with you always. May you be strengthened by his love, sustained in his strength, and by your love, in Christ. May God go with each of us this day. Amen and amen.